Occupation's got to go!
Occupation's got to go!
APAC, APAC! Occupation has got to go! applause because we stand in solidarity. We stand on the right side of history. Listen, brothers and sisters, we've seen march after march, rally after rally. But in the last, ever since the massacre that occurred during the summer months of July by the Zionist State of Israel, where everybody came clear to the world that what Zionism has done, what has imprisoned people, bombed innocent civilians, bombed children without any mercy. We know what they talk about in terms of terrorism. They are organized state terror against an innocent population that is just asking for a right to live where they historically have lived for many years. And so what you see today, what you see is ability for us to be here, and you only have a handful of diehards. The way they're still, and we'll always be a handful of diehards who will continue supporting Trump as soon as Trump's campaign is over, and we see a rise in the right. We see a rise in that right hardcore ideology that is willing to die defending racism, is willing to die defending the oppression of innocent people. So we're really happy that you're out here. There's, as always, a diverse crowd. I want to mention a personal experience. I'm a teacher in the Mission District. And when we were out defending Palestine, as we were out there defending the right for Palestinians to determine their own future, and also out there defending the right of Arab people to have their own language in San Francisco public schools, there was a parent that talked to me about the fact that she felt offended that I was just raising the issue that Arab people should have a right to their language. She was telling me because we as teachers were organizing the right of Arab people to have access to the language in this, also a racist state. And so she then told me she was offended about that. And I had a hard time looking at her and I said, you know what? It's really hard, I'm Latino. It's really hard for me to understand that idea when I feel like a second-class citizen. When people of my skin color and darker than me are getting shot by police, get an opportunity to just walk free, and then we're told it's our fault. And then if Latinos speak up, if black people take to the streets, if they demand the right, somehow it is our fault and not the system of white supremacy, not the system based on colonial genocide of indigenous people. So our struggles are connected, brothers and sisters, and that's what they hate the most. They hate the fact that it is as the way it is in their nature, as the Trumps of the world, the Netanyahu's of the world, of oppressing, of discriminating against people. It is in our nature to resist, to come together, and to demand self-determination for our people. So thank you for being out here. We're going to end with a chant. Keep fighting, because as you see, we keep winning. They're only, as the same way, you're seeing a fringe group in the U.S., the only way to push back against that is coming together, taking to the streets. Viva, viva Palestina!
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 All right, brothers and sisters, I got you. I got you. Well, we're doing this thing back and forth, but you had it. I know Shadi started off, but he's from a great organization as well, AIPAC, who organized this demo. So please give it up for Shadi.
So I'm back on the mic. My name is Sharif. I'm your MC for tonight, but I'm also the youth organizer at the Arab Resource and Organizing Center, where we recently were able to pass language pathway program for all San Francisco students. And we fought hard to get that passed into our city because of the Zionist forces that intervene in the Bay Area. At the same time, we've been instrumental with other coalitions in building up actions around Block the Vault, where we were successful in being able to blockade Israeli ships from coming in that were bringing ammunition that was tested on my people, tested on the folks in the Gaza Strip in the West Bank, then packaged as tested and sold to other state forces here in the United States and globally to be used on black and brown bodies. out on the streets. We see this form of state violence not just in Palestine, but here in the Bay Area. Did we see justice when they shot up Alex Nieto?
No!
Did we see justice when they shot up Abelcar Lopez?
No!
Did we see justice when they shot up Mario Woods?
No!
These types of racist policing tactics are trained and traded by the state of Israel. These are tactics and weapons that are used. This is the primary function of the Israeli-American relationship. So when we're out here, and we're out here against AIPAC, we're out here because of the very nature of that relationship. And we have to understand that occupation is not just in Palestine, but here in the Bay Area as well. So thank you all for coming out here tonight. We're going to do some more chanting. We have more speakers lined up for you.
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
End the occupation!
End the occupation!
End the occupation!
End the occupation!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
End the occupation!
End the occupation!
End the occupation!
End the occupation!
It's like AIPAC, you can't hide!
Countries in Latin America. Thank you.
into Palestine,
where it has the quote only democracy in the Middle East. APAC touts the rights of Israeli gays to join the military and occupy Palestinian communities. Israel cannot be further from being a democracy, since for almost a century now, Zionists and their state have carried on a campaign of ethnic cleansing, displacing Palestinians. We do not care that Israel allows gays to fight for their apartheid state any more than we care that gays may now join the U.S. military.
Palestine!
Free, free, Palestine!
Free, free, Palestine!
Free, free, Palestine!
free.
AIPAC, AIPAC, can't you see?
Palestine will be free.
Palestine will be free.
Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
End the occupation.
End the occupation.
End the occupation.
End the occupation.
All right.
Yay.
Next up.
Hi, I'm from Cal SJP. I know that we all know who AIPAC is. In our circles, obviously we rag on liberal Zionists and people who pay lip service to human rights and have centrist positions, but these aren't even those people, right? These are the worst of the worst. AIPAC has absolutely indefensible positions on virtually every Middle East issue. We have students of Palestinian background in Students for Justice in Palestine, but we also have students who are Muslim from other ethnicities. We have Iranian students, and we know that AIPAC is the group that opposed the Iran negotiation, that pushed for war with Iran, that uses Islamophobic rhetoric, that actually demonizes all Muslims and makes us feel less safe on campus. So, yeah, I want to thank everyone for being out here. Obviously, we're drawing connections between all different struggles. And AIPAC is basically at the forefront of opposing every issue of justice in the Middle East. So, yeah, thanks for coming out.
I just want to give another reminder that this Friday we will have an event at the Civic Center, UN Plaza, at 2 p.m. Stand together with Muslims and Arabs who are facing increasing Islamophobia and racism. So let's get this going. Brick by brick, wall by wall, the occupation must fall.
Brick by brick, wall by wall, the occupation must fall.
Women's issue when women and children are being targeted.
that we see our sisters over there that are fighting back. There are some beautiful pictures of women who were out there, teenagers, young girls, out there with their slingshots, and they were ready to take on the Israeli army and whatever was coming at them. And so we want to be here to say that we stand with them and that we are opposing this money that's being sent over there to demolish their homes and kill them by thousands every year. So we're happy to be here. We're going to keep drumming along with you guys this week. This is so very important for us all to be out here. We need to be loud because not enough people know the truth, and so we got to tell it. Thank you.
No to Zionism. Palestine must be free. Free!